I posted the updated outline, so please keep that in mind. Follow the updated outline, which is linked through today's class view page. And let's go to the topic. So we're still on NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement, and we are discussing the very important topic about tariff shifting, which is generally located under the HTS US General Note 12T. It is also located under Part 102 of the Code of Federal Regulations. Part 102, of course, deals with marking, and General Note 12T deals with other part, which I call a substantive part of the qualification criteria. In most of the cases, both criteria must be met. On the licensed customs broker exam, most of the questions will deal either with a Note 12T tariff shifting or with Part 102 marking tariff shifting requirement. All right, so we stopped our last class. We stopped at the topic of apparel, all right. And textiles and apparel is somewhat complex topic. It has various rules and provisions. So paying attention to the details is extremely important in this case. One part of the criteria for textiles and apparels has to do with what's known as visible lining fabric. So pretty much a lot of garments, I'm wearing it, for example, the sports coat, it has visible lining fabric right here. Pants, or as they are called in HTS US, trousers, skirts, a lot of dress apparel has visible lining fabric component to it. And visible lining fabric component usually has special provisions, special rules for tariff shifting. For example, I have a sample from a General Note 12T special rules for Chapter 62 and Chapter 61 visible lining fabric, and they pretty much say following: a change within this subheading from any other heading outside of this subheading group. So it can be either this group, or just follow down the list, must take place in order for the visible lining fabric, in order for the component to qualify under the NAFTA preferential duty treatment. So marking is, of course, is provided in the HTS US. In the Code of Federal Regulations, Part 102. Part 102 generally deals with marking requirement, but it also not a stranger to us, because Part 102 also deals with textiles and apparel tariff shifting requirements, the country version for textiles and apparel. And we already talked about general rules of origin applicable to textiles and apparel. If you recall, outside of trade agreements, we're talking about trade agreements now, but outside of trade agreements, there is no codified rule per se that determines country origin. It is usually the essential, the new article of commerce rule, which is kind of like a rule of thumb. Wherever new article of commerce has appeared, that's the country of origin of the product, provided that there are multiple countries of origin involved, of course. For textiles, there is an exception because you have to engage in tariff shifting, kind of like the one we saw in General Note 12T for NAFTA, but also for marking purposes. And recall, under the HTS US General Note 12, we have a requirement which not only includes requirement for, let's see, which not only includes the requirement for tariff shifting if one is applicable, but also the requirement for marking. And marking is available under the Code of Federal Regulations 19 CFR Part 102. 102 provisions mostly deal with, it is not the whole 102 as we saw for textiles. It is mostly, if we look at the scope, it is mostly 102 up to 102.21. So before the ones that are before 102.21, because after 102.21 you have textiles rules of origin, and those are not applicable. So most of the stuff that are located over here from 102.11 to 102.20, those are the one, and primarily the 102.20 ones, because those are the tariff shifting requirements for NAFTA. So let's take a look at the how customs examiners decided to dive into the marking requirement for NAFTA, they ask the following question: which of the following is the proper regulation for determining the country of origin of marking for girls' cotton knitted dresses imported from Mexico? Notice, Mexico is a NAFTA country, right? The call of the question is, where do you look? Well, remember I told you the tariff shifting rules, right? Over here. But if you take a look at the tariff shifting rules, those rules are only available for what? They are available for general category products, right? There is no, notice it from chapter 49, it jumps into the chapter 64. So for us, that means that the textile and apparel products, right, is the appropriate provision, because this is where you find all the textile stuff that are available for the textile article. So domestic material, of course, domestic material not for the purposes, not domestic material of the country, but domestic material of the stuff that is incorporated and calculated for the purpose of for the determination whether it is a part of that tariff shifting formula or part of that de minimis component or not. So it's important to find out the definition to define the domestic material. So domestic material means the country of origin or the same country. It doesn't have to be NAFTA, right? It can be any country in the same country as the country in which it is produced. So the way customs examiners test on this is pretty straightforward. They pretty much ask you, well, what is domestic material, right? And they ask you to fill in the blank. And it refers to the country where the material sold, purchased, produced, or leased, or acquired. The correct answer is C, where the domestic material is produced. So C is the correct answer choice. It simply tests you on the definition of this particular concept. All right. So just like with de minimis rules of origin under the general note 12 under the HTSUS for NAFTA, NAFTA marking also has de minimis definitions, and they're available under 102.13. And just like under the general note 12, HTSUS, we also see that 7% rule, right? And that 7% rule is applicable to value if it is non-textiles, and weight if it is a textile or apparel product. So your knowledge from General Law 12 is portable or almost portable, we shall see why I say almost, into the NAFTA marking rules. Let's see how this how examiners test you on this topic. So except for foreign materials incorporated into the good under HTS, so those are the exceptions, we'll get to them. Materials that do not go applicable change in tariff classification or satisfy any applicable requirement under the rules of origin when incorporated, they can be disregarded. And the only reason they can be disregarded is because of that de minimis requirement, right? If the country of origin of the good, of the country of origin, if, and you have this 7 and 10% rule, right? Let's take a look. The value of those materials is no more than 7% of the value. All right. If it's non-textile, right? Because we have except for those or except for textiles, it's 7% rule. So the examiners are testing you on the general rule, on rules of general applicability. So the key buzzwords here is the value and 7%.